Start.
Hi everyone, I am Dr. Kamlesh Golab, professor, physiology department, Anantara Pincham with Homeopathic Medical College. Today we are going to discuss one more practical point of view, that is clinical examination of a sensory system. So this clinical examination of a sensory system, for that one basic rule is that patient should be conscious. And we are going to examine different body parts, okay, such as upper limb, neck, chest, abdomen, lower limb and back. So in this order we are going to examine this sensory system, and we have divided this examination into 3 points, that is superficial senses that we are going to examine, we are going to examine deep sensations, and we are going to examine cortical sensations. So we will examine this system in three steps. First, superficial sensations we will examine, then deep sensations and cortical sensations. So let us start this discussion with superficial senses. So first, superficial senses that we are going to examine, that is light touch, or that is also called as fine touch or a crude touch. So for this particular examination, we will take help of cotton wicks. Okay. So we will ask person to close his eyes first, and we are going to just touch this cotton wicks at particular place, and we will ask him to identify it. Okay? Yes.
Touch.
Now, can you identify it?
Touch.
So this is a light touch or fine touch, and these sensations are carried by anterior spinothalamic tract. So we are going to examine in same sequence. Upper extremities, both sides, then at chest, and then at lower extremity, the same sequence we are going to follow. Next sensation that we are going to examine, that is pressure pain. That pressure pains, this sensation is carried by anterior spinothalamic tract. For this particular purpose, for this examination, we are going to use blunt object. Okay, we are going to press blunt object at various places on the on body. Patient, we are going to ask him to close his eyes, and we are asking him to identify the area of pressure pains. Okay,
touch.
Okay. Now here,
touch.
He is able to identify it. We have to perform same test at different regions of the body. So his anterior spinothalamic tract is well. The next is examination for superficial sensations, that is sensation of temperature. For this examination, we are going to take help of test tube. One test tube, as it is with me, it is filled with hot water, and another test tube with a cold water. So first I am going to touch one test tube, that is hot test tube, and I will ask him to identify the particular sensations. Okay? Yes, which is this one?
Hot.
Good. Now, what about this?
Cold.
So these sensations are good. So we are going to examine all over body regions. We are going to examine at another extremity, lower extremity, upper, lower, back. Everywhere we will perform this examination. So these sensations of temperature and pains, these are carried by lateral spinothalamic tract. So you can say lateral spinothalamic tract of this particular subject or patient, it is working properly. So next we will go for deep sensations. Just turn it off. Right? So superficial sensations we have finished, which includes light touch or fine touch or crude touch, is one and the same, which is carried by anterior spinothalamic tract. Then we have finished examination of pressure pain, which is carried by anterior spinothalamic tract. Then we have finished examination of temperature pain, which is carried by lateral spinothalamic tract. So all these three comes under superficial sensations. Now we will start examination of deep sensation. So in deep sensation, first examination comes, that is sense of position. Okay, for sense of position, sense of position and joint sense, all this is carried by tract of Golden and Bowden. So for sense of position, I am going to, this normal sense of position is called as proprioception. So this proprioception, it is carried by tract of Golden and Bowden. Just I am going to move one upper limb of this particular subject in various direction like this, and I will at last I will fix it in one position, and I will ask him to put other extremity in that position. Yes, like this. So you can say his proprioception is good. One more way of examination, that is finger. You can move finger in all direction, okay, and then just fix it in one direction and ask him to identify that direction of with that thumb. Now, yes, tell me.
Down.
Okay, it is downward. He is able to identify it. Now, yes, tell me.
Up.
Upward. He is able to identify. So you can say that sensation of joint sense and sense of position is normal in this particular subject. Good. Then, if this particular position, sense of position or joint sense get altered, that is called as sensory ataxia. So sensory ataxia, in that there is uncoordinated, slow, clumsy, voluntary movements. So this sensory ataxia is usually get confused with cerebellar ataxia. For this particular purpose, there is one test which is called as Romberg's test. If you perform Romberg's test, you can say, if you can able to differentiate this sensory ataxia with cerebellar ataxia. I will show you how to perform Romberg's test. Ask a person to stand in direct position, feet should be close towards each other. He should stand in direct position first with open eyes. Open your eyes, okay? First eyes should be open, and ask him to stand in direct position. He should not fall. Yes, he is not falling at any side. Now ask him to close his eyes and observe him carefully whether he is falling on one side or not. So he is not falling on any side. So this is Romberg's test is negative. Now sit. So what is the significance of this test? So if the patient's eyes are open, when eyes are open, these visual sensations helps to maintain a proper position of that person. And in closed eyes, visual sensations are not helping in maintenance of a normal position. That's why Romberg's test comes positive. That is called as patient is having sensory ataxia. So never forget Romberg's test. The next sensations that we are going to perform, that is sense of vibrations. So for examination of sense of vibration, we are going to take help of tuning fork. We are going to give vibrations to the tuning fork, and just we are going to place it on bony prominences at various places. So we will ask him to identify that sense of vibration. So again, same rule is there. Patient should close his eyes. Close your eyes. Just keep hand like this. Okay. Give vibrations to the tuning fork and place it at bony prominences.
Yes.
Yes, he is getting it. Okay. We will perform another extremity. Getting it?
Yes.
Yes, he is getting it. So sense of vibrations, we have to test it. You are supposed to test on all four extremities, back, everywhere. So this sense of vibrations. And one more test comes on the deep sensations, that is deep pain or pressure pain. For that particular use, you are going to use pointed objects. You can even use needle. Or just to take deep pain or pressure, you can pinch, okay, and ask him to identify it, okay, deep pains. Or you can use pointed objects, but while using needles, care should be taken that he should not prick to the patient, like this.
Touch.
Okay,
touch.
He is getting it.
Touch.
That is a deep pain. So again, you can turn here. So in deep sensations, we have studied first test, that is sense of position, that is called as proprioception, then joint sense, the significance of sense of position and joint sense is with that Romberg's test, Romberg's sign and sensory ataxia that we have studied. Then we have studied sense of vibration, then we have studied deep pain or pressure, deep pressure. All these sensations, that is deep sensations, are carried by track of Kohl and Burdeck. So it is very, very essential to know track of Kohl and Burdeck in detail before going to perform this test, as we studied last time. Then last, that is cortical sensations. that again we are going to examine two types of taste under these cortical sensations. One is tactile localization. For tactile localization, again we are going to use cotton wisps, that particular cotton wisps we are going to touch at various places, and we will ask him to identify that particular place. Okay,
touch.
Now here also,
touch.
He is able to recognize it. So tactile localization is proper, properly in this case. Then next is tactile discrimination. Tactile discrimination is ability of a person to know. Tactile discrimination is the ability of a person to distinguish two different objects at a shortest distance. This is called as discrimination. For this particular purpose, we are going to use two pointed objects and we will ask him to discriminate it or to differentiate it. Okay? Now tell me, how many objects are touching to you?
One touch.
One touch. Now?
Two touch.
Two. Now?
One touch.
Okay. Now?
One touch.
Now?
Two touch.
Two touch. So this is called as tactile discrimination. It is the ability of a person to distinguish two different objects at a shortest distance. And lastly, that is stereognosis. Stereognosis is ability of a person to identify known objects with close eyes. For this purpose, we are going to give him familiar objects such as key or coins like that. And we will ask him to identify it with close eyes. Now, again, I will give you one object. Madan, you should identify it without looking towards it. Yes, what is this?
Coin.
Yes, he is able to identify a coin without looking towards it. Now, what is this?
A key.
Key. Okay, he is able to identify this key without looking it. So this is called as a stereognosis. Again, these cortical sensations like tactile localization, tactile discrimination and stereognosis, all these three are carried by Trefungol and Burdick. Okay, so this lesion is definitely going to cause loss of tactile localization, discrimination, and this stereognosis is definitely going to affect the ability to identify known objects with close eyes. It is going to affect, which is called as a stereognosis. So you should remember these words very well. So that's all with this clinical examination of sensory system. In next session, we will discuss in detail clinical examination of a motor system. Thank you.